সো কাম করে কোয়েশ্চেন নাম্বার থ্রি, কোয়েশ্চেন নাম্বার থ্রি ইজ এ বি সি ডি ইজ এ রেক্টেঙ্গেল এন্ড পি কিউ আর এন এস আর দ্য মিড পয়েন্টস অফ দ্য সাইডস এ বি বি সি সি ডি এন্ড ডি এ রেসপেক্টিভলি সো দ্যাট দ্য কোয়াড্রিলেটারাল পি কিউ আর এস ইজ এ রম্বাস। কোয়েশ্চেন নাম্বার থ্রি গিভেন দ্যাট এ বি সি ডি ইজ এ রেক্টেঙ্গেল, ওকে রেক্টেঙ্গেল মিন্স প্যারালেলোগ্রাম হুজ অপোজিট সাইডস আর ইকুয়াল এন্ড ওয়ান অ্যাঙ্গেল ইজ ওয়ান অ্যাঙ্গেল ইজ 90 ডিগ্রি, ওকে। So suppose this one is A, B, C, D is a given rectangle and this given that P, Q, R and S are the midpoints of the sides A, B, B, C, 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 D and D respective. So we have to prove that P, Q, R, S is a rhombus. That means we have to join this one P, Q. So this one, okay. So this one is P, Q, R and S. So given A, B, C, D is a rectangle and P, Q, R and S are the midpoints of the sides A, B, B, C, C, D, L, D, A respectively. Okay? So we have to prove that. We have to prove that PQRS is a rhombus. So at first we have to prove, at first we should prove PQRS is a parallelogram, and after that if you prove that all the sides are equal, then it becomes a parallelogram, okay. So it becomes a rhombus. That means if all the sides of a parallelogram are equal, then it is a rhombus. So there is a construction you have to join AC. So construction, let us join AC, okay. So proof, so in this case directly you can write, so in triangle ADC, SN are the midpoints of the sides AD and CD respectively. Okay. Therefore, directly you can write, therefore, SR parallel AC and SR equal to half of AC. Within bracket you write by midpoint theorem. Okay, and give number 1. Okay. Since S is the midpoint of AD, R is the midpoint of CD, so in triangle ADC, joining the two midpoints must be parallel to the third side and equal to the half of the third side. So SR is parallel to AC and SR is equal to half of AC. Okay, so just now give the equation is number 1. Similarly, in triangle ABC, P and Q are the midpoints of the sides AB and BC respectively. Okay, so therefore P PQ is parallel to AC and PQ equal to half of AC. Again, within bracket you just write midpoint chhoda, by midpoint chhoda and give number 2. So according to 1, SR is parallel to AC, SR is half of AC. According to 2, PQ is parallel to AC and PQ is half of AC. That means from 1 and 2, PQ is parallel to SR and PQ is equal to SR. So therefore from equations 1 and 2 we get PQ parallel to SR and PQ equal to SR. So therefore PQ RS is a parallelogram. Okay, so PQ RS is a parallelogram. So all of you know that the opposite pairs of parallelograms are equal, so therefore you can also write therefore PS is equal to RQ or QR, which you can give equation number 3 also. This equation number 3 and this equation number 4. Okay, so after proving that PQRS is a parallelogram, so now prove that, okay, so again look at these two triangles, since it is given that ABCD is a rectangle, that means AB is equal to CD, opposite side of the rectangles are equal. Again, P is the midpoint of AB, that means AP equal to PB, that means AP equal to half of AB. Similarly, AP equal to P is the midpoint of AB, that means AP equal to PB. So now actually we will prove these two triangles are congruent. If you prove these two triangles are congruent, then we will prove these two sides are equal, and automatically all the sides becomes equal. Okay, so you can write like this: since ABCD is a rectangle, so therefore AB is equal to BC, or opposite side of a rectangle. You just divide by 2, therefore half of AD equal to half of BC. Okay, so half of AD means you can write AS, and half of BC means you can write BQ, since S and Q are the midpoints of AD and BC respectively. Okay, so you just give this equation as a number 5. You will use this 5. Okay, so now just take the these two triangles. So now in triangle ASP and triangle BQ, ASP and BQ P. In this case, AS is equal to BQ from 5. Okay. Next, we know that the angles of our rectangles are 90 degrees. That means this angle 90 degrees. So angle SAP equal to angle QBP. Both are 90 degrees. Okay. Again, AP equal to BP, since P is the midpoint of AB. So using these three things, that means SAS, that means side angle side. So therefore triangle ASP is congruent to triangle B BQP, which is SAS. So if two triangles are congruent, then automatically you will know that corresponding parts must be equal. So therefore, SP is equal to QP, specifically, which is suppose 6.